Hi again, it's Lacey Covanda. I have a ministry called Freedom You Fitness. Through Revelation Wellness, I became an instructor where I get to lead faith, then fitness classes at our church. If you can't join me at church, then this is a way you can join me in working out, our bodies while God works in our hearts. So we always focus on part of God's word for the day, just asking him to move in our hearts while we work out our bodies. So today I have a quick strength workout for you, 45 seconds of work followed by 15 seconds rest. I'm only going to do it one time through. However, if you feel like you could do another round or two, then you can just start it back over. Or if you remember the moves, then set your own timer, 45 seconds work, 15 seconds rest. So today we're going to be in Joshua 1:6. And this is the Lord talking through Joshua. And he says, "Be strong and courageous, because you will lead these people to inherit the land I swore to their forefathers to give them. Be strong and very courageous. Be careful to obey all the law my servant Moses gave you. Do not turn from it to the right or to the left. Then you will be successful wherever you go." And then he goes on in verse 9. "Have I not commanded you, be strong and courageous? Do not be terrified. Do not be discouraged, for the Lord your God will be with you wherever you go." So this is before Joshua is leading the Israelites into the promised land that God had promised them. But he's saying, be strong and courageous. And it's not a being strong and courageous in our own strength, but it's being strong in the Lord. Because he says, be careful to observe my commandments. Follow God in all our ways. Like, and he will make our paths straight. We'll have success wherever we go because our eyes are going to be fixed on him. And so therefore our success is his glory. It's not a success, a worldly success that we're fixed on. But it's the success that we are living in his will and in his ways and bringing him glory. And that is good for us. That is good for us when God is glorified. So as we are doing a strength exercise, we're going to remember, be strong and courageous. Be strong and very courageous. Don't be afraid where God's leading you. If he has shown you that he's going to take you somewhere, or he has something planned for you or good for you, we can be strong and courageous, fixing our eyes and our hearts on him, not veering to the left or to the right, but fixing our hearts on him. And if we do veer one way or the other, he's faithful to draw us back. We just confess and we get back in his light. So while we do this strength exercise, we're going to be strong and courageous, and this is in the Lord. And God will be with us wherever we go, whether we're at home, whether we're at work, whether we're on vacation, whether we're on a mission trip, whatever we're doing, God is with us. So grab a set of weights if you have them. Otherwise, soup cans work great. Bricks, paving stones, something like that. I've used those, or laundry detergent. That works too. So 45 seconds of work, followed by 15 seconds rest. All right. And we're just going to move because we can. If you cannot do this in love, push pause. Come back to it either later during the day or another day. All right? Let me grab my weights. Start our timer. Our first move, we're going to do a wide leg squat. It's called a sumo squat. You don't have to weight these if you don't want to. Ready? Begin. So squat, raise it up. Keep that chest lifted. Squeeze through the backs of your legs. 45 seconds. Whatever you can do. Good job. Sometimes those new places God has for us can seem scary or tricky. But if he says it, it will happen. We just get to follow. Might not happen in our timing. 20 more seconds. Good job. Keep going. Chest lifted. Can you do 10 more seconds? Come on. Good job. 5, 3, 2, 1. All right. 90 degrees in your elbow, and you're going to sidearm raise. Ready? Set. Begin. Keeping your elbows, your shoulders in the same plane. 45 seconds here. Keep those shoulders on your back. Turn to the side. It doesn't have to be quick. Good movement and good form is always better than quick movement. Lots of reps with bad form. All right, tuck that belly button toward your spine. 20 more seconds. Like our song, set it on fire. Your arms on fire. It's all good. It's all good. 7 seconds, come on, we can do it. Be strong and courageous in the Lord. Don't go to the right or the left, follow him. Rest, rest. All right, we're gonna do curtsy lunges, and that's stepping back and behind. Back and behind, coming to the top and switching sides. Hold your weights if you want, otherwise set them down, it's up to you. Begin, so it's back and behind. If this bothers your knees at all, just step straight back into a reverse lunge. I run out of room here, but go to the side, curtsy lunge. Push up through that heel. Good job. Maybe we've forgotten that God is with us wherever we go. So maybe we remember today. Fix our hearts, our eyes on him. 10 more seconds. You're doing so good. Good job. Can you smile? 5, 3, 2, 1, rest. All right, you're going to bend over. We're going to row it up. All right, I'm going to turn around so I can see my timer. You're still resting, though. These are called low rows. You're going to squeeze your back muscles right back here. Lead with your elbows. Go. Flat back. Don't let your head drop. Look up. Fix your eyes on a point of the floor. Feel that in your lower back, your shoulders, whatever pace you want for 25 more seconds. Good job. So maybe you can tell we're doing legs, then arms. 15 seconds. Good job. Your eyes on the Lord. Be strong and very courageous. When our eyes are fixed on him, our paths will succeed. Rest. Rest. All right, we're going to do calf raises for 45 seconds. We're going to mix them up too. So just starting with regular ones. Ready? Begin. Raise them up. Good job. We're going to point our toes in here in a little bit. Then we'll finish pointing our toes out. All right, point your toes in. 15 seconds pointing your toes in. It might feel awkward. It's all good. Squeeze through those calf muscles. Good job. 2, 1, take your toes out. Like a ballerina. Good work. God has new plans, good plans for us as we follow him. He is always faithful. Rest. Shake those out. All right, so this is going to be a core move. Feet hip width apart. We're going to slide our weights down our side, letting our core guide our weights and our movement. Ready? Begin. So side, up. Feel that in your core. You may not feel it right away, but you will the longer we go. Good job. Side to side flexion. Drag those weights down your leg. Good job. Keep that belly button toward your spine. That'll help engage your core. You're halfway done. I'm feeling it. Surely you're feeling it. Almost there. 10 more seconds. Side to side. If you feel it in your back a little bit, it's good. 2, 1, rest. Come on down. Grab one or both weights. We're going to put our weight in our back pocket for 45 seconds. If you need more, you bring your legs up. Straight back. Ready? Begin. Weight in your back pocket, 45 seconds. What do you need to remember to be strong and courageous about today? Where is God asking you to go? What's your you're not willing to follow yet. Maybe it's making a phone call. Maybe it's asking for forgiveness for a strained relationship. You can be strong and courageous in Him. You have 5 more seconds. Maybe it's starting something new, something in your community or your church, rest, or with your family. Come on up. One or both weights. We're going to stagger our feet, arms overhead, tricep extensions. You're going to drop the weight behind you. Ready? Set. Begin. We'll switch our legs halfway through. Keep those elbows as still as you can. Weight goes behind you. Keep going. I'm going to turn, face you a little bit. Engage that core. All right, switch those legs. Begin when you're ready. Brace your back. Tuck that core in. Good job. You got 10 more seconds. Good work. 5, 3, 2, 1, rest. You did the whole set. Good job. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 8 moves. 8 moves alternating between legs, upper body, some core mixed in there. So if you would like more, go ahead. Push play again. Or do some more on your own if you can remember the intervals. 45 seconds work, 15 seconds rest. That's all I got for you today. Other than to remember to be strong and courageous in the Lord. Let's go ahead and stretch a little bit before we go. I'm going to keep my shoes on, but you can take yours off if you want. Either way. We're going to inhale, bring our arms up really tall. Exhale, track those shoulders on your back. Inhale up, exhale down. Take really big shoulder circles here backwards. And then roll them forward. Why do we stretch? Stretching is just as good for our muscles and our bodies as all of our weights and cardio that we can do, because it's like elastic. It's like we can stretch it, we can compress it through working out, and then we can lengthen it. We need both that compressing and the lengthening to be well, so that if we make a funny step or we step off a curb wrong, we have a little bit of stretch, but then we also have the strength to not be injured or not necessarily fall. All right, inhale up one more time. Exhale, take your hands straight out to the side. Fold forward, flat back. And just bow out when you're ready. Bring your weight onto the balls of your feet a little more. Let your head hang. Inhale, come about halfway up. Exhale, hold on down. Slowly roll up, one vertebrae at a time. Good, let your head be the very last thing that comes up. Just drop one shoulder to your ear. Stretch that neck. Slowly roll it forward. Pause at the middle. Roll it to the other side. When you're ready, roll it on down to the center. And just rock side to side with your head. Nice and slow. Coming to the center, slowly lift your head up. Good. We're going to take our legs wide, wide, straight arms out, flat back, round out when you need to. Just walk into one leg, bend this leg. Be able to stretch on the inside of that leg. Inhale to the top. Exhale as you go to the other side. One more time, each side. Last time. Coming to the center.
Take your hands behind you, using your hands to get into that forward fold a little more. Good. Just twist to one side. Set your back knee down, get into that runner stretch. Hands on either side of your front foot. Be gentle with this part of your body. Inhale as you sit back, flex that front foot. Bend over it as much as you can. Inhale as you come forward, both hands on the inside, really bend into the front leg. Exhale as you sit back, point this front leg, bend over again. Good, take that leg back, bring the other leg forward. Find this runner's lunge, stretch. Good, sit back, flex the front foot, hold over that leg. Inhale as you sit forward, both hands on the inside of the front leg, really bend into it. Inhale as you sit back, point the front foot, and bend over. Good, take that knee back on your hands and your knees. You're gonna tuck your toes under, push that tailbone high. Really walk your feet right and left. Then either tiptoe forward or take your hands backwards. End in that forward fold. And just slowly roll on up. Good. Good work today. If you need to stretch more, go ahead and do that. I'll just close us in prayer. God, we thank you that in you we can be strong and courageous. That you've given us your word so that we know how to follow you. You've given us your spirit so that we can trust you and know you, that we can be alive and empowered by you. So God, help us follow you with whole hearts. That we wouldn't go to the right or to the left. That our hearts and our minds would be fixed on you. God, and as you lead us, we would have that courage and the strength so that your glory is made known through us. So God, search our hearts. Just guide our steps as you always do. Help us to be faithful to you. Help us to remember that no matter where we go, you are with us. God, we give you all of ourselves, all of our hearts, our lives, our desires, our plans. Change them so that they align with yours. Thank you for the gift of life and the gift of movement. May we not take any of it for granted. God, we praise you and give you all the glory. It's in Jesus' all-powerful name that we pray. Amen. Thanks for joining me. I hope you have a blessed day. That you see the glory of the Lord all around you. That you enjoy Him and then share His love with others. Bye.